Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
G'day. My name is Mahmoud Ahmadinejad, and my thing is Ahmad.
I've heard that before.
You have. You're a good man.
Yeah, we're seeing you tonight, actually. Michael Danby is putting on a cabaret, a fundraiser.
Is he? Oh, terrific.
Yeah, and you'll be performing
there. I will. Oh, terrific.
Yeah, and I'd love you to do something really political.
Like, really, really heavily political.
Yeah, heavily political.
Yeah.
And tell us what side you're really on.
Well, I'm basically. Are you familiar with Bob Green from the Browns?
Yes, I'm familiar with Bob Brown from the Greens.
No, Bob Green from the Browns.
I'm setting up, now that Bob's gone, I can set up my own political party.
Bob Green.
No, I'm setting up the Greener Party.
The Greener Party.
Do you like that? Party. Everyone, welcome to the Greener Party.
I'm happy to be part of. I would love to be.
We're going to offer free everything.
Free everything?
Everything's free.
Free cocaine?
Free everything. Sex, coke, drugs.
Whatever it is.
Free cars. We'll throw in Oprah Winfrey as well. You can have her,
I'd be very happy to be part of your political aspirations, Henry.
Would you?
Because I've always believed that, that's where you need to be, in the public eye, so that all that neurosis that arose from the Warsaw Ghetto will just leave you, and you'll be able to live a normal life without as many schmonces as you have.
I don't need all the things.
Because this studio is cluttered with schmonces. I've never been to a studio more cluttered with schmonces. But these are all from your shop, aren't they? Didn't you have a shop?
I did have a shop once.
It was a terrific shop.
The Camel Bazaar
was a terrific shop.
The Phoenix rises from the ashes every day.
Well, terrific, it's terrific.
It was a great shop,
even if
it's
rented. Yeah.
Now, what is really going to happen in the future now, do you believe, in politics? I really want to know what you see as the next step in political life.
In my political career?
Yours, in relation to the rest of Australia.
Well, I can tell you that I'm running again for the sex party in 2013 for that Shire of Warringah.
Is it the free sex party or just the sex party?
It's just at the moment it's the sex party, but what about the greener sex party?
The greener, freer sex party. Yeah. So you can do anything.
The greener pastures. Sex party. I'm running again for the sex party and I'm running against Tony Abbott because I hate his guts and... the quicker we get rid of him out of the political spectrum, the better. Unfortunately, he's been a formidable opponent of Julia Gillard because he's been very negative without presenting any real evidence.
What about Malcolm Turnbull? What do you think?
Doctor, no.
What about Malcolm Turnbull? Is he an alternative?
Well, Malcolm Turnbull's a pots, I went to university with him.
He's a nice guy, though. That's his problem.
He's a nice guy, but he's not really a nice guy. He's a pots. He's just an opportunistic pain in the ass.
That's why I'm not going into politics, because I'm not an opportunist.
No, you're not.
And I'm not malleable. That's obvious.
I'm getting well paid for this.
I'm not a yes
man. I got a couple of salmon on rye bread.
Yeah, don't forget the capers. That's your caper. But, I haven't asked you what's your shtick. You asked me what's your caper.
Yeah, but what I'm doing is I'm running again, and I have aspirations to become the Prime Minister of Australia. So I know I've let the cat out of the bag, but that's my plan. And when it is, the Jews will suffer.
AT for PM.
Yeah, AT for PM. That's exactly it.
You like that?
Yeah, or PMT. Yeah.
PMT. Yeah. And talking about PMT.
Prime Minister Tayshus.
Yay. Can't wait for that. Well, it's been really great to have you while you're in Melbourne to capture you in the studio.
You're lucky because a lot of organisations wanted me and they were happy to pay.
They can't find a cage to keep you.
They couldn't find a caged tiger, but you're a good man. Exactly. And I'll always do. I'm always very happy to work with you. And I wish the shtick, another 5,000 shows.
Yeah, okay. That'll be 3,500, 5,000.
And all my Israeli friends, shalom, shalom uvracha. And I know a great tattoo place in Goa that every Israeli should get a little tattoo on the tuches.
And that's where you can hide it.
Just we'll to forget that you are Jewish.
We'll be back.
When you leave the army, and you've been 3 years, and the psychological pleasure of Hezbollah and Nasrallah,
we have
Jordan and Syria, and this and that.
Man,
you have to go
up,
to Goa.
He's not quite as affable as ostentatious.
Go to
His
Goa,
get
completely tattooed.
Going to against halacha. To watch something with
to
him,
goyim.
Talk to Eddie Tamir.
Every Israeli will learn to become goyim.
Movies and careers. You can go now.
My pleasure.
Thank you. Thanks.
Thank you.
Sandy Goodman, also known as
Shalom Aleichem.
The Prime Minister, future Prime Minister
PMT,
of Australia.
Prime Minister Tayshus.
We'll knight you, Sir Austin.
You're a good fellow.
You've got too many names. See you in a while.
I understand you'd like me to hear your confession?
Yes, I would. Not exactly a confession. I haven't yet done the deed.
I'm here for you, Mark.
Is it possible for me to know a woman in the biblical sense?
Are we talking about sexual intercourse?
I think so.
Outside marriage?
My penis speaks to me, Father Brendan. This therapist suggested I could work with a sex surrogate who would be sensitive to my unusual needs.
In my heart, I feel like he'll give you a free pass on this one. Go for it.
Yeah, maybe. Yes, it's good.
Hi, Mark O'Brien.
Your money's on the desk over there.
Yes, it is.
That was the wrong way to start off.
It really was. Shall we start again?
Please. You start.
I'm not a prostitute. You don't have to pay me up front. And there's a limit to the number of sessions we can have. The limit is 6. Shall we get undressed?
Sure.
First session. He was extremely nervous.
Let's forget about it.
Mark, do you want to see this woman or not?
No.
Well, it's too late.
What floor?
18th floor.
What kind of therapist is she?
She's a sex therapist. Today they're working on simultaneous orgasm.
What's that?
You're going to start to listen to signals from your body. That way you'll be able to have some control.
Oh, God.
I understand even among non-believers, the most common expression of sexual ecstasy is, oh, God.
Picture yourself as a 6-year-old boy. Do you blame him for getting polio?
What is she like? Cheryl.
She's the most wonderful person on the planet.
I don't usually meet with clients outside of work.
We don't have to do much talking. I just want people to say, hey, who's that gimp with that beautiful blonde? What happens when people become attached to each other? Maybe this is a bad idea.
I think you've done a great thing.
She adores me, and I can get pretty kinky. Am I sharing too much, Father?
Go on.